Here are some quick barbecue tips for you to enjoy this summer on the next episode of Elegance and Sophistication. Welcome back. The joys of barbecuing. For those out there, this month, May, is barbecue month. And what better way to celebrate that by celebrating it on the first real holiday of the summer, Memorial Day. Here are some quick tips I thought that you would love to know to make your barbecuing moments an enjoyable one to use for years to come. When barbecuing, try not to place the meat over an open flame. When using wooden skewers for a shish kebab, soak the skewers in water for about 30 minutes before placing them on the grill. This will help prevent the skewers from burning or smoking. The number of charcoal briquettes depends on the type of food to be cooked and the size of your grill. Scatter the coals in a single layer, so to cover an area slightly larger than the area of food that you'll be cooking is going to take up. Then gather them into a small pyramid in the center and soak with lighter fluid. Please, please, please do not use gas or kerosene. Let stand for about 5 minutes before lighting. After lighting, allow 45 minutes for the coals to burn down. The coals are ready when they appear ash gray in color in the daytime and a red glow at night, but with no flame at nighttime. If the fire is too hot, then distribute the coals out a little bit more. To adjust the heat, add warm coals from the perimeter around the fire's edge, or if you have an adjustable grill, lower the grill. It is easy to overcook steaks on the barbecue since the heat is difficult to control. Overcooking is one of the largest causes for tough steaks. Check often if they are done and remove from the grill as they're cooked to your preference. A little non-stick cooking spray goes a long way on the grill. Yes, spray it on the rack prior to cooking and it will prevent meat from sticking to ease the cleanup afterwards. Probably the most flavorful cut of steak is the sirloin or New York strip, but they are not always tender. The most tender cut of steak is the ribeye or tenderloin, and of course, it's the most expensive. One of my secrets to tender and delicious steaks is the marinade. Yes, marinating the meat before grilling will add flavor and tenderize it. Meat should always be marinated in the refrigerator. Any leftover marinade that has been in contact with raw meat should be disposed of, and do not save or reuse the marinade. Here is an easy recipe for making a marinade. You will need one small onion, minced, 4 tablespoons olive oil, 5 tablespoons soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, 2 tablespoons of white vinegar, 1 teaspoon of liquid smoke. Now, if you don't know what liquid smoke is, it's in the barbecue section of your local grocer. If you can't find it, you don't really need it. It just gives it a little bit more of a smoky flavor. Some people don't even prefer it. I, for one, don't prefer it, but some people do. And 1 teaspoon black pepper. Combine all the ingredients in a saucepan and simmer on low heat for about 5 minutes. Cool before using. Marinating overnight is most effective, but if this is not practical in some cases, marinate at least 3 hours, turning the meat periodically. If you want to know how your steak is done, the surest method is to use an instant read meat thermometer. For medium rare, cook to 145 degrees Fahrenheit. For medium, 160 degrees Fahrenheit. And for the well done, cook to 170 degrees Fahrenheit. If you don't have a meat thermometer, you can get a fair idea using my following method. Hold your left hand in front of you with fingers closed together and thumb extended. Use the index finger of your right hand and push on the fleshy part of your left hand between your index finger and thumb. It will feel fairly soft. This is how steak should feel if it's cooked rare. You have to feel it to touch it. I mean, it's just like that. Kind of spongy. From medium to medium rare, extend your left hand, but spread out your fingers, and poke the same spot with your right index finger. It will feel a little firmer. This is how a steak cooked medium to medium rare will feel. And for well done, make a fist with your left hand and poke again. It should have very little give. This is how a well done steak will feel. Always, when cooking, use thongs for turning your meat. Do not puncture the meat with forks. Yes, I have learned this, that you do not puncture your steak with forks. Some people used to dab it and jab it and put the juice and marinade all over it, and you're not supposed to do that. I just learned that. Holes in your steak will allow the juices to escape, resulting in a tough steak, and you don't want a tough steak. After removing meat from the grill, allow it to sit for 5 minutes before even cutting into it. This allows the juices to settle and keep the meat tender and flavorful. And finally, for people who have a stand-up barbecue, stand-up barbecues tip over easily and can cause serious burns. Keep children and pets at a safe distance. I do hope that you can use these great tips for your next barbecue extravaganza and make people envious towards your barbecuing cooking techniques. But remember to keep it elegant and always sophisticated. I'll see you next week with some more helpful tips. Bye for now. I need some steak. Okay, everybody, who wants some steak? I got steak, chicken, hamburger, hot dogs. I just love barbecuing, don't you?